chemical tests for oxalate. Oxalates are salts of oxalic acid containing the oxalate ion. The oxalate ion is a dianion with the formula C2O4 2-. Upon protonation, the oxalate ion forms a commonly known compound, oxalic acid. Commonly known oxalate salts are sodium oxalate and potassium oxalate. Also, the oxalate ion reacts with a calcium metal ion to form an insoluble precipitate of calcium oxalate, which is a primary constituent of most of the common kinds of kidney stones. Our aim here is to test for the presence of oxalate ion in a given salt. The tests to determine the presence of oxalate ion are preliminary tests and confirmatory tests. Let's first look at the preliminary tests of oxalate. They are dry heating test, potassium permanganate test, concentrated sulfuric acid test. Dry heating test. Materials required: original salt, lime water, test tubes, test tube holder, and Bunsen burner. Procedure: take a small quantity of the salt in a test tube and heat it over the Bunsen burner. On heating, oxalate undergoes decomposition to evolve the colorless and odorless gas, carbon dioxide. Cover the test tube containing salt with an empty test tube and collect the gas. Now, pour lime water into the test tube filled with gas. The lime water, which is a dilute solution of calcium hydroxide, reacts with the carbon dioxide to form insoluble calcium carbonate, which turns lime water milky. Potassium permanganate test. Materials required: original salt, dilute sulfuric acid, potassium permanganate solution, test tube, test tube holder, droppers, and Bunsen burner. Procedure: take a small amount of the salt in the test tube. To this, add a small volume of the dilute sulfuric acid using a dropper. Boil the contents over the Bunsen burner to boil off any gas evolved. To this, add a little more dilute sulfuric acid. Then, add potassium permanganate solution dropwise using another dropper. Heat the contents of the test tube over the Bunsen burner. Potassium permanganate decolorized due to the formation of colorless manganese sulfate along with carbon dioxide gas is liberated. Concentrated sulfuric acid test. Materials required: original salt, concentrated sulfuric acid, lime water, test tubes, and a dropper. Procedure: take a small amount of the salt in a test tube. To this, add a small volume of concentrated sulfuric acid using a dropper. Oxalate reacts with concentrated sulfuric acid to form a mixture of carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide gases. Cover the test tube containing salt with an empty test tube and collect the gas. Now, pour lime water into the test tube filled with gas. The lime water, which is the dilute solution of calcium hydroxide, reacts with carbon dioxide to form insoluble calcium carbonate, which turns lime water milky. Next, we look at the confirmatory tests for oxalate. They are calcium chloride test, potassium permanganate test. Calcium chloride test. Materials required: aqueous solution of the salt, dilute acetic acid, calcium chloride solution, dilute nitric acid, test tube, test tube holder, droppers, and Bunsen burner. Procedure: take a small amount of aqueous solution of the salt in a test tube. To this, add a small amount of dilute acetic acid using a dropper. Boil the contents of the test tube over the Bunsen burner to boil off carbon dioxide gas. Now, Add a small amount of calcium chloride solution using another dropper. Oxalate reacts with calcium chloride to form a white precipitate of calcium oxalate. Using a dropper, add dilute nitric acid to the precipitate and warm the test tube over the Bunsen burner. On warming, the precipitate of calcium oxalate dissolves in dilute nitric acid due to the formation of soluble calcium nitrate. Potassium permanganate test. Materials required: original salt, dilute sulfuric acid, potassium permanganate solution, test tube holder, droppers and Bunsen burner. Procedure: take a small quantity of the salt in a test tube. To this, add a small volume of dilute sulfuric acid using a dropper. Warm the test tube to 60 to 70 degrees Celsius. Now add a few drops of potassium permanganate solution using another dropper. Potassium permanganate decolorized due to the formation of colorless manganese sulfate along with carbon dioxide gas is liberated. Precautions: handle the apparatus and chemicals carefully. To collect the gas, completely cover the test tube containing the solution with an empty test tube. Use droppers to take the reagents from the bottles. Wear lab coat and gloves while performing the experiment.